What is going on, everybody? It is Mike. Welcome back to Tech 24/7 TV. Apple just released beta 2 for iOS, iPadOS, and we are covering all the new features in this video. Let's get right into it. Here we have on my left, beta 1 on the iPhone SE 2. We have beta 2 running on the iPhone 11 Pro Max. And we see here that the calendar icon, which shows the date, obviously, and the day of the week, looks distinctly different from one another. So here on the iPhone SE 2, we see that the day is fully written out. Here it's abbreviated on the right, and there's a thicker font for the date shown. Now let's go ahead and go into the widget picker here. The widget picker actually is a lot cleaner on beta 2 than it is on beta 1 completely. It's actually much more visually appealing to me. You get a better sense of what the changes are. So adding widgets here in the widget picker, they just look cleaner. There's more of a border. They're more prominent. The text is cleaner. There's more padding, I think, in between the widgets. It looks just better, in my opinion. Now, if I want to go ahead and add a widget, let's just say here, I'm going to go ahead and add the smart stack. Now, you see the smart stack has a distinct color. It's blue, batteries is green, calendar white, so on and so forth. So if I click on smart stack, now the color of smart stack, the add widget button here at the bottom is actually color matched to each one of these. So now depending on which widget I'm going to pick, if I go back here, go to files, it's blue. If I go to fitness, it's this green color. So each add widget button is going to be color matched. It's going to be specific to the widget that you're adding. Also here in beta 2 is going to be two new widgets. One is going to be the files widget. So the files widget gives you the ability to go ahead and add your most recently found files. It's going to either be in a small or a large widget. So basically a 2x2 or a 2x8 widget size. That's kind of cool. Actually, I use that a lot because I use files as my replacement for Dropbox because I hate paying them any money. Now let's go to the next. Here's going to be the podcast up next. This was not here for me in beta 1, but I heard some people saying that it was. Up next for podcast is now available. It shows either in a 2x2, 2x4, or in a 2x8 size. So small, medium, large. New inside the photo widget is going to be a small, medium, and large size widget for you. I actually like the large size widget, though I don't think it looks good on my iPhone 11 Pro Max. I'd like to see something a little bit smaller, maybe. I guess it seems like it's kind of an odd size. I will say this again. These widgets would look really good on a very large iPad, say 15 inches. Now the battery widget here, this was in beta 1. I actually didn't see it till beta 2. Now you see, if you're looking at my phone, on the battery widget, it actually shows the battery indicator for the watch on the right, the phone on the left. Anytime that you have your watch powered off, it's going to give you obviously the battery indicator as a visual perspective, but it's also going to go ahead and give you the percentage. Since I always have my watch connected, it does show or doesn't show the battery percentage. I wish they actually did show the battery percentage. Like if you tapped on it, it'd give you the percentage. That would actually be nice. Another big change here is going to be the weather widget is finally fixed, where it's showing your current location and not reverting back to Cupertino. So that's fixed as well. If we look at the reminders widget, the reminders widget's been cleaned up. One, the number of items in the reminder list has been relocated from underneath the icon to the top right-hand corner. It's just visually, but looks better and cleaner. Now we also look at the notes indicator. The note actually has a little bit more text that's going to be readable on the screen in comparison to the first beta. Control Center for me has been updated. There's better padding between all the different controls in Control Center. Also here, now beta 1, I had the ability to go ahead and add favorite accessories and have them controllable in there. Now I have those same accessories, but they're no longer favorited, and the home button is just now kind of taking up a majority of, I'd say, about 25% of the screen real estate, where there was this animation where I could actually click on it. It would pop open really nice. It actually does it on my iPad, but it would open up real nice. It's not working here in beta 2, so hopefully that's just some kind of local configuration that I have on my device. Let's pop into settings. We're going to see that there's some new iconography for a few things. So if we go into iCloud, and also the family sharing setting behind that has been updated as well, reorganizing who's in the family and what services are being streamed and shared. If we go into settings, phone, now we see that the phone call section has been reorganized. It's got some different icons. Here we have the ability to go ahead and change the incoming call notifications when your phone is unlocked. I wish they could actually do that for when it's locked as well, because the whole screen takeover is still not my thing. We talked about the banner notifications, the compact UI elements. If your phone is unlocked, how it actually doesn't take over the whole screen like it does when it's unlocked or in iOS 13. I really like that feature, and I hope they allow that to compact UI notification when the phone is locked as well. Now, if we go to settings, music, there's a new feature here for motion cover album art, which is actually really cool. It actually looks really cool. This is going to be either available on all the time on Wi-Fi, or it's going to be off. Now, if I go into music, it's not for all the albums, but it's going to be for the albums that Apple suggests for you, like the albums from Apple. If I look at here, look at my favorites mix, see how the album art's moving. And what is actually kind of cool, if you scroll down into where it says made for you, if you look at the speed that it's scrolling or the speed that it is kind of changing or morphing, the favorites mix and the get up mix moves faster. So it's supposed to, you know, music that's going to be higher tempo. The chill mix moves actually very slow. And the new music mix is kind of a combination or somewhere like a hybrid between all three of them. I would say maybe being updated based on the beat per minute of the music that's going to be in there. So that's actually really cool. And also here, a little haptic feedback when you're using the music controls. Very slight. And it's actually the haptic feedback simulates the button is going to be on either side of where you're pressing. So if I'm pressing the rewind button, it feels like it's going to be in the bottom left-hand corner. If I push the fast forward button, it's in the bottom right-hand corner. Say that right? Bottom left, bottom right. You know what I'm talking about. Now, I wonder if I use the now playing control. It doesn't do that from the control center, so it's only going to be in music, but it still looks clean as hell. I really like the new design of music, and I hope that they continue to move in this direction because it looks really, really good. Now, if I was looking at this artist, let's say I go ahead and focus on this artist. Artist page is a little bit redesigned. There's more padding in between, you know, the artist's name, the genre that it's in. And it just looks cleaner, much more visual appeal to it. In my last video regarding all the new features on the iPad, I found this quick switch feature, which is at the bottom. So basically the pages icon that shows how many pages that you have on your home screen is you can push on it and quickly switch between the number of pages opposed to swiping across. Now, if you're one of those folks that has a HomePod and you live in a multi-user household, you can now set the music preference service for your HomePod. So if you go into Home, go into Home Settings, and if you click on your name, it'll show right below the section where it shows Show Me on Apple TV, it shows Media, and you can set your default preferences for music and podcasts. Now that will require an update on the developer side, so you probably don't have any apps other than Apple Music if it's in there. Now let's go over to App Library. A couple changes here I think worth notable. One bug, I think, in my opinion, if we look here, I turned on my notifications, which I wouldn't actually suggest for anyone. So you see here in this top right-hand corner, I have recently added, it shows the Gmail with 128 notifications or 128 unread emails. If I go into productivity, it actually shows the same app with the same number of notifications. Not that Gmail is misrepresenting the number of emails, but Apple's showing this app in two different sections, which I don't think necessarily makes sense from a consumer perspective. Let me know what you think in the comments below, but I'd rather just see this app only represented once, either in recently added or in the appropriate folder. That's the thing that I would rather see. Now, if I go ahead and long press in the center of this, you can now go ahead and delete apps from here. So if I want to go ahead and delete, let's just say, I'm just thinking what app I want to delete. Let's say I'm going to delete the Gmail app because right now you're making me upset. So deleting Gmail will also delete its data. If I click delete, it's gone from the device. Now also, if I go ahead and let's say if I want to go to an app that's on my home screen or on one of the first two pages of my home screen, if I click on it, I can choose to one, remove from home screen, or which puts it in the app library, or two, delete it. I'm going to go ahead and remove from home screen, and that takes that app out of there, and it's now inside the app library, which is nice. Now there's a couple small, I would say minor visual changes. If we look at the clock app on beta 1 versus beta 2, there's definitely thicker hands and the way that it's designed on beta 2 versus beta 1, better, you know, I say visual read. Not too many people, I think, realize this, that the time that's shown in the clock app is actually real time. Also, if you are going into wallpaper, let's go into wallpaper settings / wallpaper and do preview. Right, for your home screen wallpaper no longer shows some big amorphous blob like it does on the preview on beta 1. And I think last but not least, but this is definitely my favorite, if you are watching some type of video that has picture-in-picture, so let's go to the TV app. Now the picture-in-picture video is basically resized to the bottom half of my screen or bottom third of my screen. If I double tap on the window, it actually gets smaller and then it gets smaller again. So there's now two or three different sizes for picture-in-picture video. And it works on the iPad as well, which is nice. So you can always just double tap on the video and it'll take up three different sizes. Now for the iPad, there's a couple subtle changes to the iPad. First, if you are handwriting text, you now have the ability to go ahead and strike through text to go ahead and select it in addition to circling the text like you had in beta 1. And there is a new sidebar submenu in Photos where it shows recently deleted as well as recently added. That's actually kind of cool. I hope that they bring this same design sidebar element to a collapsible sidebar to Home. That's something I'd really like to see there as well. That would be great. Now, those are all the features I found in the latest beta after playing with it for a couple hours. I'm sure that there is much, much more. Let me know what you have found in the comments below. Now, I do have a follow-up video planned kind of talking about how everything has progressed, you know, after a few days. Make sure you are subscribed with notifications to be alerted when that content drops. I am Mike. This is Tech 24/7 TV. I'll catch you in the next one.